Now let us call ourselves to worship. And this is the judgment, that the light has come into the world, and we loved darkness rather than light. God is light, in whom there is no darkness at all. For God sent the Son into the world, not to condemn the world, but that the world might be saved through him. Everyone who does evil hates the light and does not come to the light. But all who do what is true come to the light. Please pray with me. Holy God, our hope and strength, we give thanks for your word made flesh, for the life that death cannot destroy, and for the light that darkness cannot overcome. Enlighten our minds and enliven our hearts by the power of your Holy Spirit, so that we may testify to your light, share the life of Christ with a hurting world, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Is merciful. How do we know? God gave us his Son to suffer the shame of the cross, to save us from hardness of heart, that seeing him who died for us, we may repent, confess our sin, and receive God's overflowing love. In Jesus Christ our Lord, let us confess our sins together. Most gracious God, look with mercy upon your family gathered here, for whom our Lord Jesus Christ was betrayed, given into corrupt hands, and suffered death upon the cross. Strengthen our faith and forgive our betrayals as we enter the way of his passion. This is the new covenant I made with you, says the Lord. I will put my law in your heart. I will remember your sin no more. Friends, believe the good news of the gospel. In Jesus Christ, we are forgiven. Thanks be to God.
Reading from Mark 14, 26 to 50. Peter's denial foretold, Jesus prays in Gethsemane, the betrayal and arrest of Jesus. When they had sung the hymn, they went out to the Mount of Olives, and Jesus said to them, "You will be all become deserters, for it is written, I will strike the shepherd, and the sheep will be scattered. But after I am raised up, and I will go before you to Galilee. And Peter said to him, even though all become deserters, I will not. Jesus said to him, truly I tell you, this very day, this very night, before the cock crows twice, you will deny me three times. But he said vehemently, even though I must die with you, I will not deny you. And all of them say the same. Then they went to a place called Gethsemane, and he said to his disciples, sit here while I pray. He took with him Peter and James and John, and began to be distressed and agitated. And he said to them, I am deeply grieved, even to death. Remain here and keep awake. Going a little farther, he threw himself on the ground and prayed that if it were possible, the hour might pass from him. And he said, Abba, Father, for you all things are possible. Remove this cup from me, yet not what I want, but what you want. He came and found them sleeping, and he said to Simon, Simon, you are asleep. Could you not keep awake 1 hour? Keep awake and pray that you may not come into the time of trial. The spirit is indeed willing, but the flesh is weak. Again, he went away and prayed, saying the same words. And once more he came to them and found them sleeping, for their eyes were very heavy, and they did not know what to say to him. He came a third time and said to them, are you still sleeping and taking a rest? Enough! The hour has come. The Son of Man is betrayed into the hands of sinners. Get up. Let us be going. See, my betrayer is at hand. Immediately, while they were still speaking, Judas, one of the 12, arrived, and with him there was a crowd with swords and clubs from the chief priests, the scribes, and the elders. Now the betrayer had given them a sign, saying, the one I will kiss is the man. Arrest him and lead him away under guard. So when he came, he went up to him and said at once, Rabbi, and kissed him. Then they laid hands on him and arrested him. But one of those who stood near drew his sword and struck the slave of the high priest, cutting off his ear. Then Jesus said to them, have you come out with swords and clubs to arrest me as though I were a bandit? Day after day I was with you in the temple teaching, and you did not arrest me. But let the scriptures be fulfilled. And all of them deserted and fled.
Oh,
Our second reading comes from Mark, chapter 14, verses 53 through 72. They took Jesus to the high priest, and all the chief priests, the elders, and the scribes were assembled. Peter had followed him at a distance right into the courtyard of the high priest, and he was sitting with the guards, warming himself at the fire. Now the chief priests and the whole council were looking for testimony against Jesus to put him to death, but they found none. For many gave false testimony against him, and their testimony did not agree. Some stood up and gave false testimony against him, saying, "We heard him say, 'I will destroy this temple that is made with hands, and in 3 days I will build another not made.'" Yet even on this point, their testimony did not agree. Then the high priest stood up before them and asked Jesus, "Have you no answer? What is it that they testify against you?" But he was silent and did not answer. Again, the high priest asked him, "Are you the Messiah, the Son of the Blessed One?" Jesus said, "I am. And you will see the Son of Man seated at the right hand of the power and coming with the clouds of heaven." Then the high priest tore his clothes and said, "Why do we still need witnesses? You have heard his blasphemy. What is your decision?" All of them condemned him as deserving death. Some began to spit on him, to to blindfold him and to strike him, saying, "Prophesy." The guards also took him over and beat him. While Peter was below in the courtyard, one of the servant girls of the high priest came by. When she saw Peter warming himself, she stared at him and said, "You are also with Jesus, the man from Nazareth." But he denied it, saying, "I do not know or understand what you are talking about." And he went out into the courtyard. Then the cock crowed, and the servant girl, on seeing him, began to say to the bystanders, "This man is one of them." But again he denied it. Then after a little while, the bystanders again said to Jesus, said to Peter, "Certainly you are one of them, for you are a Galilean." But he began to curse, and he swore an oath, "I do not know this man you are talking about." At that moment, the cock crowed for the second time. Then Peter remembered what Jesus had said, "Before the cock crows twice, you will deny me three times." And he broke down and wept.
Just as it was morning, the chief priest held a consultation with the elders and scribes and the whole council. They bound Jesus, led him away, and handed him over to Pilate. Pilate asked him, "Are you the king of the Jews?" He answered him, "You say so." Then the chief priest accused him of many things. Pilate asked him again, "Have you no answer? See how many charges they bring against you." But Jesus made no further reply, so that Pilate was amazed. Now, at the festival, he used to release a prisoner for them, anyone for whom they asked. Now a man called Barabbas was in prison with the rebels who had committed murder during the insurrection. So the crowd came and began to ask Pilate to do for them according to his custom. Then he answered them, "Do you want me to release for you the king of the Jews?" For he realized that it was out of jealousy that the chief priest had handed him over. But the chief priest stirred up the crowd to have him release Barabbas for them instead. Pilate spoke to them again, "Then what do you wish me to do with this man who called the king of the Jews?" And they shouted back, "Crucify him." Pilate asked them, "Why? What evil has he done?" But they shouted all the more, "Crucify him." So Pilate, wishing to satisfy the crowd, released Barabbas for them. And after flogging Jesus, he handed him over to be crucified.
Oh, heart for blood and wound and for Schmerz und voller Horn. Oh, heart zu Sport gebunden mit einer Dornenkron. Oh, heart sonst schön gezieret mit höchster
Fourth reading comes from Mark 15, 16 through 20. Then the soldiers led him into the courtyard of the palace, that is, the governor's headquarters. And they called together the whole cohort, and they clothed him in a purple cloak and twisted some thorns into a crown they put on him. And they began saluting him, "Hail, King of the Jews!" They struck his head with a reed, spat upon him, and knelt down in homage to him. After mocking him, they stripped him of the purple cloak and put his own clothes on him. Then they led him out to crucify him.
compelled a passerby who was coming in from the country to carry his cross. It was Simon of Cyrene, the father of Alexander and Rufus. Then they brought Jesus to the place called Golgotha, which means the place of a skull. And they offered him wine mixed with myrrh, but he did not take it. And they crucified him and divided his clothes among them, casting lots to decide what each should take. It was 9 o'clock in the morning. When they crucified him, the inscription of the charge against him read, "The King of the Jews." And with him they crucified two bandits, one on his right and one on his left. Those who passed by derided him, shaking their heads and saying, "Aha, you who'd destroy the temple and build it in 3 days, save yourself and come down from the cross." In the same way, the chief priest along with the scribes were also mocking him among themselves and saying, "He saved others, he cannot save himself. Let the Messiah, the King of Israel, come down from the cross now so that we may see and believe." Those who were crucified with him also taunted him.
Thank you.
the death of Jesus. When it was noon, and darkness came over the whole land until 3 p.m. At 3 o'clock, Jesus cried out with a loud voice, "Ele, ele, lama sabachthani," which means, my God, why have you forsaken me?" When some of the bystanders heard it, they said, "Listen, he is calling for Elijah." And someone ran, filled a sponge with sour wine, put it on a stick, and gave it him drink, saying, "Wait, let us see whether Elijah will come and take him down." Then Jesus gave a loud cry and breathed his last. And the curtain of the temple was torn in two from top to bottom. Now, when the centurion, who stood facing him, saw that in this way he breathed his last, he said, "Truly this man was the Son of God."
Thank you.
chapter 15, verses 40 through 47. There were also women looking on from a distance. Among them were Mary Magdalene and Mary, the mother of James the younger, and of Joseph and Salome. They used to follow him and provided for him when he was in Galilee. And there were many other women who had come up with him to Jerusalem. When evening had come, and since it was the day of preparation, that is, the day before the Sabbath, Joseph of Arimathea, a respected member of the council, who was also himself waiting expectantly for the kingdom of God, went boldly to Pilate and asked for the body of Jesus. Then Pilate, wondering if he was already dead, summoned the centurion. He asked him whether he had been dead for some time. When he learned from the centurion that he was dead, he granted the body to Joseph. Then Joseph brought a linen cloth, and taking down the body, wrapped it in the linen cloth and laid it in a tomb that had been hewn out of the rock. He then rolled a stone against the door of the tomb. Mary Magdalene and Mary, the mother of Joseph, saw where the body was laid.
Please pray with me. Lord Jesus, one of us betrayed you, another denied you, and all of us have forsaken you. Yet you remain faithful to death, even death on a cross. Strengthen us so we do not turn aside, but follow you through sunlight and shadow alike. For the final victory belongs to you, Lord Jesus. Amen.